गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो फार वी हैड बीन डिस्कसिंग अबाउट मॉलिकुलर ऑर्बिटल थ्योरी इन विच वी हैड डन प्रीवियस प्रैक्टिस ऑफ लीनियर कम्बिनेशन ऑफ एटॉमिक ऑर्बिटल्स, काउंटिंग द नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन द टू एटॉमिक ऑर्बिटल्स एंड फिलिंग देम इन द मॉलिकुलर ऑर्बिटल्स. वी हैड सीन दैट व्हेन द एटॉमिक ऑर्बिटल्स कंबाइन देन दे फॉर्म बॉन्डिंग मॉलिकुलर ऑर्बिटल एंड एंटी बॉन्डिंग मॉलिकुलर ऑर्बिटल. The bonding molecular orbital and antibonding molecular orbital can be sigma bond or pi bond. When S and S overlaps, they form sigma bond. When PX and PX overlap on a head-on basis, axially, then they form sigma bond. But when they overlap laterally, then they form pi bond. So there were sigma bonding molecular orbital, there were sigma antibonding molecular orbital, there were pi bonding molecular orbital and pi antibonding molecular orbital, and they were arranged in the order of their energy level. So we had seen the molecular orbitals of we have seen molecular orbitals of hydrogen, helium, helium 2 plus, iron, lithium 2, beryllium 2, boron 2, carbon 2 and nitrogen 2. We found out by calculating the number of bonding electron and antibonding electron the bond order. Bond order was found out by the formula number of bonding electron minus number of antibonding electron by 2. It gave us an idea about how many covalent bonds can be possible between two atoms. Like in case of nitrogen, we had seen atomic orbital of nitrogen and atomic orbital of another nitrogen, 1s2 1s2. They combined to form sigma bonding 1s2 and sigma antibonding 1s2. So as of now, we will not fill the electrons. We will just write the orbitals and we will fill up electrons at first here. So it was 1s, then 2s. Sigma bonding 2s, sigma antibonding 2s, and then the p orbitals were combining. I will need this space, so I will erase it. Let this be at the same energy level. Two p of nitrogen and two p of nitrogen. These were the atomic orbitals this side, and these were also the atomic orbitals this side, and this was the energy level. These were the atomic orbitals of nitrogen, atomic orbitals of nitrogen. How many electrons are there in one nitrogen atom? 7. How are they filled up? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. This side 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. We had seen that the laterally overlapping pz and py orbitals, they were forming degenerate molecular orbital. Degenerate molecular orbital means of equal energy level. These are degenerate 2p pi bonding MOs. It is degenerate because the energy level is in the same, they are in the same level. And bonding, sigma bonding 2p x, this was pi bonding 2p y, and this was pi bonding 2p z. Its antibonding orbitals were like this, pi antibonding 2p y equal to the energy level of pi antibonding 2p z. And sigma antibonding 2px. Now we will fill up the electrons. There are 7 electrons this side and there are 7 electrons this side. Total there are 14 electrons. So we will fill up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 13 and 14. Here we see that bond order is equal to number of bonding electron minus number of antibonding electron by 2 is equal to how many bonding electrons are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 minus 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. By 2 is equal to 6 by 2 equal to 3. That means 3 covalent bond between nitrogen atom is possible. So to this extent the bond order was helpful in finding out even the number of covalent bonds. This pattern was correct for O2 and N2, for C2 and N2. C2 and N2, this pattern was correct. But there is a small change in the order of these orbitals, molecular orbitals. There is a small change in the order of these molecular orbitals in case of O2, F2 and Ne2. In case of O2, F2 and Ne2, there is a small change. The camera became blurred, so I am repeating it once again. This side, these are the atomic orbitals of nitrogen. Atomic orbitals of nitrogen. They are combining to form the molecular orbital, sigma bonding 1s, sigma antibonding 1s, sigma bonding 2s, sigma antibonding 2s, pi bonding 2py, pi bonding 2pz, and sigma bonding 2px. There were 7 electrons of nitrogen this side, and there were 7 electrons of nitrogen this side. They are filled up again 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. Now, bond order is found out by subtracting number of bonding electron minus number of antibonding electron and then dividing by 2. So, 10 minus 4 by 2 is equal to 6 by 2 equal to 3. This 10 came from these bonding orbitals. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And 4 came from antibonding orbitals. 1, 2 and 3, 4. So here the 3, the value 3 which came shows the 3 covalent bond between the nitrogen atoms. Now this pattern was correct for molecules up to C2 and N2. This pattern was correct for molecules up to C2 and N2. But for O2, F2 and Ne2, the pattern changed. Okay, the pattern became like this. Everything remains same up to this, just that the sigma 2px came below pi 2py and pi 2pz. So if I need to show you the molecular orbitals of O2. Say if I need to show you the molecular orbital of O2. Molecular orbital of O2. Then I will keep all of these orders same. Only I will change this part. This was molecular orbital for N2. This side I will make molecular orbital for O2. This was the AMO diagram for N2. Here I will make AMO diagram, that means molecular orbital diagram for O2. So I will require to write atomic orbitals of oxygen, AO of oxygen atom, AO of oxygen atom. So first will be 1s, 1s, then 2s, 2s, and then 2p, 2p. How many electrons are there in oxygen? There are 8 electrons in the oxygen. This is 1s2, 2s2, and 2p4. This will be 1s2, 2s2, and 2p4. Fill up the electrons 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So totally there are 16 electrons and they will form molecular orbital. It will form sigma bonding, 1s, sigma antibonding 1s, sigma bonding 2s, sigma antibonding 2s. Here what is going to be changed is that sigma bonding 2px will come down, sigma bonding 2px will come down. Sigma bonding 2py will go up. This will remain same. Sigma antibonding 2py and sigma antibonding 2px. How do we name it? We can make a square also, we can make a circle also. This is sigma bonding 1s2, or this will fill up later on. This is sigma antibonding 1s, sigma bonding 2s, sigma antibonding 2s. This is sigma bonding 2p x, this is pi bonding 2py, pi bonding 2pz, pi antibonding 2py, pi antibonding 2p z, and sigma antibonding 2p x. Now filling up of electron will be there. There are 8 electrons this side and there are 8 electrons this side. 16 electrons are to be filled up. So we'll fill up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16. So according to Lewis electron dot structure, you will find that all the electrons were paired. But here we find that they are having unpaired electrons. Whenever any molecule will have unpaired electrons in its molecular orbital, it will become paramagnetic. We will call it as paramagnetic substance. If it had been paired up, like in this molecule, all the electrons are paired up. So this is a diamagnetic molecule. So remember this, that if there are unpaired electrons in the molecular orbital, we will call it as paramagnetic. If all the electrons are paired up, we will call it as diamagnetic. The pattern of molecular orbitals arrangement is different at this region. Rest everything is same. See, in this region, I am making a difference in the color. Okay. In the similar way, we can write down the molecular orbital diagram for F2. For that, what we have to do? We have to just add one more electron here, one more electron here, and it will get paired up. You can be asked to write down the molecular orbital for the O2 minus ion, O2 2 minus ion, or O2 2 plus ion. In that case, if it is 2 minus, then add 2 electrons. If it is 2 plus, then take out these 2 electrons also. So O2 is very much possible, because if you find out the bond order in this case, that means number of bonding minus number of antibonding by 2 will be equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So there are 10 bonding electrons minus antibonding. How many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 4 by 2 equal to 2. So see, oxygen can form double bond. In case of nitrogen, we had seen that it was coming 3. In case of oxygen, we are seeing that it is coming 2. So well it was able to quantify the number of covalent bond between the atoms. So it had a mathematical explanation. So mathematically it was possible to explain. Using MOT, mathematically it was able to be explained that how many covalent bonds will be there, or whether the bond between the two atoms will be possible or not. What do you think, that if you write down the molecular orbital diagram for any two, what bond order would be there? Does any two molecule exist? Does any two molecule exist? Let us convert this molecular orbital diagram into molecular orbital diagram of NE2. So what I have to do for that? Some simple modification. MO diagram of NE2, neon 2. Let us see. This was 2px antibonding. How many electrons will be there in that? All electrons will be filled up, isn't it? All electrons will be filled up. So there are 10 electrons here and 10 electrons here. So we fill up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, and 17, 18, 19, 20. From where 20 came? 10 from one neon and 10 from another neon. It will be diamagnetic because all electrons are paired up, and bond order you will see. Bond order will be number of bonding electrons is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And number of antibonding electrons is also equal to 10 divided by 2 is equal to 0. That is why NO2 is not possible. NO2 molecule is not possible. It is an inert monoatomic gas. It is an inert monoatomic gas. It is not diatomic. Okay. So this was all about the molecular orbital diagram. Now what you can do is, you can make a chart. Okay. Take a chart paper, and in the chart paper, write down the molecular orbital diagram starting from hydrogen up to neon. Not more than that is required to be learnt in class 11th and even in class 12th. Later on in higher classes, you will be seeing the molecular orbital diagram of heteroatomic molecule. But the happy news is that in class 11th, you have to only study the molecular orbital diagram of homoatomic or homodiatomic molecules. Homodiatomic molecules. Okay. Thank you.